around every meat packer in Chicago, and the result was what I just told you. They did hire me.
Yeah.
How much did I get?
$25
a week was my starting salary. Go to the store today and buy a few bananas and a glass of milk. You're up to $25. How did I make out? How did I do that? Well, luckily, working for a meat packer, we had wholesale market for employees, and we lived mostly on lamb shanks, which at that time were 10 cents a pound. If any of you cooks have ever shoppered for lamb shanks today, you know you don't get them for 10 cents a pound. I worked there until 1949, and oh, I forgot to mention this. During my freshman, sophomore vacation, I worked at the H.H. Meyer Packing Company in the sausage department. They hired me. A tragedy occurred. Quickly, I'll tell you this. It was a tragedy. Probably many people haven't been in a packing house where they stuff the sausage in large casings, put them on a tree, cook them, and put them in the smoke house. In addition to that, you have to brand them with the U.S. Inspected Pass, which is edible colored ink.
What color?
You know, the dumb college boy, what he did? He didn't dry the bologna and it ruined a whole 1,000 pounds. Because the ink spotted every one of them. And the foreman said, "You dumb college boy." Yeah, I worked in that position for a couple of years, and then they brought me down to Cincinnati, where I worked for, as I said, 37 years. I started out as the glorified office boy. Now, I'm not going to brag. This has happened. This is the way it happened. I started out as a glorified office boy, setting type in the old-fashioned drum where you put little slots of slugs of letters in a wheel, and you turn that wheel and printed your price list. That was my beginning. Well, anyway, after all those years, I became the provision manager, then I became the manager, and just before I left, they gave me the grand title of vice president. Now, how did I get here? Well, I'll have to say it this way. Linda Gonzalez is a former president of the Railroad Council of Broward County. Cindy Panera was the secretary of the same organization and still is. Well, I used to work at our nursery. What we were doing, there was three of us. We were basically maintenance of the ground. We mowed and we hoed and we cut and trimmed and so forth. And as I grew older, they said, "Harold, you should be working this hard in the hot sun." I said, "Fine." At that time, Sidney Panero, big Florida Medical Center, said, "Well, you don't want to do nothing, Harold. Why don't you come and be a volunteer at the Florida Medical Center?" And I've been there for 9 years, and that's where I met these beautiful girls.
Still got it, Grandpa.
I'm on sabbatical leave. Really not, wasn't supposed to be this way, was it? But it happened this way, and I'm probably back to work tomorrow.
You better be.
I said, I retired in 1974. I came to Florida. I previously bought a house in 1956. As a vacation home, because my dad and mother used to come down and pay rent in the summer. I said, "Why do that? Let's buy a house." So I bought this little house. We're trying to remodel a little bit right now. So here I am. I never thought I'd be sitting here. But I hope all of you have the same experience. I guess I have a very simple formula. Number one, I was never destined to sit around a swimming pool playing cards. Number two.
He forgot.
Anybody work for Coca-Cola? I don't drink soft drinks. Sugar. I still say that if you're active and keep your brain active, the body will take care of itself. There's one thing I hate to say this because of who is here.
Oh, no.
But I still like girls. I do get a lot of sleep. One thing about that laboratory, it tires me out. When I get home, I can take a 2-hour nap. And then I go to bed early, too. I don't stay up late watching television.
Grandpa!
Do you have a computer?
Yeah. I have a computer, and believe it or not, I'm on Facebook.